Hello mga Cockpit Angels! Welcome back for another Mathinique episode. This is Teacher Mika.
And this is Teacher Joymi.
Today, we will talk about solving problems involving sets with the use of Venn diagram.
After going through this module, you are expected to solve problems involving sets with the use of Venn diagram. But before we proceed, let's have these Venn diagram stories. First, we have the set of wet clothes as set A, the set of dry clothes as set B, and the set of all clothes as set U. Second, we have the set of girls as set C, the set of cheerleaders as set D, and the set of all students as set U. And lastly, we have the set of girls as set E, the set of boys as set F. We also have the set of varsity players and the set of all students as set U. Now, what stories can you make about these Venn diagrams? You may discuss this with your parents, guardian, your siblings at home, or to your teacher and classmates during your online classes.
What is Venn diagram? Mathematically speaking, a Venn diagram is a diagram used to illustrate the relationship among sets. Also, a particular set may be highlighted by shading the regions containing the elements of the set. Venn diagrams are useful in showing set operations. Given two sets A and B and a universal set U, the following Venn diagrams represent some relationship and operation. Number 1. The shaded region describes all the elements of set A. Number 2, the shaded region describes all the elements of set B. Number 3, the shaded region is the union of set A and set B, thus represented by A union B.
Number 4, the shaded region shows the intersection of set A and set B, thus represented by A intersection B. Number 5, the shaded region does not include any elements of set A, thus describes A prime or A complement. And number 6, the shaded region does not include any elements of set B, thus describes B prime or B complement.
Number 7, the shaded region contains all the elements of set A that are not in set B, thus represented by A minus B. Number 8, the shaded region contains all the elements of set B that are not in set A, thus represented by B minus A. Number 9, the shaded region does not include any elements of set A or set B, thus represented by the quantity of A union B complement. And number 10, the shaded region does not include any elements that belong to both set A and set B, thus represented by the quantity of A intersection B complement.
We'll now find out how are we going to use these Venn diagrams in solving worded problems from real-life situations. In Figure 1, which is the Venn diagram with two sets, we can see that set A and set B divided the universal set into four regions. While in Figure 2, which is the Venn diagram with three sets, we can see that set A, set B, and set C divided the universal set into eight regions.
Let's have sample problem number 1. A group of 40 students were asked whether they use either Facebook or Twitter or both. 23 of these students use Facebook and 25 use Twitter. The questions are, letter A, how many use Facebook only? Letter B, how many use Twitter only? And letter C, how many uses both Facebook and Twitter? Here's the solution. Using Venn diagram, we will illustrate two overlapping circles. The first circle will be named as F, and the second circle will be named as T. We need to find the intersection of the two sets by adding the number of students who use Facebook and number of students who use Twitter. Then, subtract the sum by the total number of students. So the cardinality of F plus the cardinality of T is equal to 23 plus 25 is equal to 48. So 48 minus 40, the total number of students, is equal to 8. Therefore, the cardinality of F intersection T is equal to 8. Thus, 8 students use both Facebook and Twitter. To answer letter A, how many use Facebook only, we will just subtract 23 by 8. That gives us 15 as the number of students who use Facebook only. And lastly, to answer letter B, how many use Twitter only, we will just subtract 25 by 8. That gives us 17 as the number of students who use Twitter only.
Sample problem number 2. In an interview, 154 students play Mobile Legends. That will be represented by capital letter M. 232 students play Candy Crush. That will be represented by capital letter C. And 26 students play both Mobile Legend and Candy Crush. If each student plays at least one of these games, how many students were interviewed? Here's the solution. Let M be the set of students who play Mobile Legend. So the cardinality of M is 154. Next, let C be the set of students who play Candy Crush. So the cardinality of C is 232. And let the intersection of M and C be the students who play both Mobile Legend and Candy Crush. So the cardinality of the intersection of M and C is 26. Now let's have this Venn diagram. First, we will use the intersection to represent the 26 students who play both Mobile Legend and Candy Crush. Take note that we have 154 students who play Mobile Legend, but we need to subtract this by 26 so we will get the number of students who play Mobile Legend only. That is, 154 minus 26 is equal to 128. And to get the number of students who play Candy Crush only, we will subtract 232 by 26. So 232 minus 26 is 206. Finally, to get the total number of students interviewed, just add 128, which are the students who play Mobile Legend only, 206 students who play Candy Crush only, and 26 students who play both Mobile Legend and Candy Crush. Thus, 128 plus 206 plus 26 is equal to 360 students. Therefore, there were 360 students interviewed.
Let's have sample problem number 3. A total of 250 students visited an education booth. 100 students visited the math booth, while 125 visited science booth, and 13 visited both the math and science booth. The questions are, letter A, how many students visited the math booth only? Letter B, how many students visited science booth but not the math booth? Letter C, how many students visited either the math booth or the science booth? And letter D, how many students visited neither the math booth nor the science booth? So here are the solutions. Let M be the set of students who visited math booth. And let S be the set of students who visited science booth. Let's have the following given. Letter A, the universal set is equal to 250. That is the total number of students who visited the education booth. Letter B, the cardinality of M is equal to 100. Those are the students who visited the math booth. Letter C, the cardinality of S, which is equal to 125. Those are the students who visited the science booth. Letter D, the intersection of M and S is equal to 13. Those are the students who visited both math and science booth. Now let's have our Venn diagram. Step number 1. Always start with the intersection of two sets if it is given. M intersection S is equal to 13. Step number 2. Since the cardinality of M is 100, then students who visited math only is 100 minus 13 is equal to 87. Step number 3. Since the cardinality of S is equal to 125, then students who visited science only is 125 minus 13 is equal to 112. And lastly, step number 4. To get the number of students who did not visit any of the booths, we will solve for M union S, that is 87 plus 13 plus 112 is equal to 212. And then subtract the sum from 250, which is the total number of students. Thus, 250 minus 212 is equal to 38. Therefore, for letter A, there were 87 students visited the math booth only. Letter B, there were 112 students visited the science booth but not the math booth. Letter C, there were 212 students visited either the math booth or the science booth. And letter D, the students visited neither the math booth nor the science booth were 38.
Last sample problem. 550 students were enrolled for the school year 2020 to 2021 online classes due to pandemic. 170 of them enrolled in math class, 211 enrolled in science class, and 224 enrolled in English class. 39 enrolled for both math and science, 40 enrolled for both math and English, and 56 enrolled in both science and English. 21 students enrolled in 3 subjects. Now the questions are, how many students are enrolled in math only? Second, how many students are enrolled in science only? Third, how many students are enrolled in English only? And lastly, how many students will not be taking up any of the 3 subjects? This time, we will use a Venn diagram with 3 sets. And the trick here is to work backwards. So we will start with step 1. Start from the intersection of 3 sets. That is 21 because there are 21 students enrolled in 3 subjects. Step 2. There are 56 students enrolled in both science and English. So the intersection of S and E is 56. But we still have to subtract it by 21. So 56 minus 21 is 35. Step 3, there are 40 students enrolled for both math and English. So the intersection of M and E is 40, but we still have to subtract it by 21. So 40 minus 21 is 19. Step 4, there are 39 students enrolled for both math and science. So the intersection of M and S is 39, but we still have to subtract it by 21. So 39 minus 21 is 18. Step 5, there are 224 students enrolled in English class. So for us to get the number of students enrolled in English class only, we will subtract 224 minus the sum of 19, 21, and 35. So that is 149. Step 6. There are 211 students enrolled in science class. So to get the number of students enrolled in science class only, we will subtract 211 by the sum of 18, 21, and 35. So that is 137. Step 7, there are 170 students enrolled in math class. So to get the number of students enrolled in math class only, we will subtract 170 by the sum of 19, 21, and 18. So that is 112. And step 8, since there are 550 students enrolled, and adding up all the number of students enrolled in the key classes, 112 plus 18 plus 21 plus 19 plus 137 plus 35 plus 149, that is 491. Hence, 550 minus 491 is equal to 59. Therefore, there are 59 students who did not enroll in any of the 3 subjects. To sum it up, there are 112 students enrolled in math only. Next, there are 137 students enrolled in science only. Next, there are 149 students enrolled in English only. And lastly, there are 59 students who will not be taking up any of the three subjects.
It's time for your practice. A group of 50 students went in a tour in Palawan province. Out of the 50 students, 24 joined the trip to Coron. 18 went to Tubata Harif, 20 visited El Nido, 12 made a trip to Coron and Tubata Harif, 15 saw Tubata Harif and El Nido, 11 made a trip to Coron and El Nido, and 10 saw the three tourist spots. The questions are: letter A, how many of the students went to Coron only? Letter B, how many of the students went to Tubata Harif only? Letter C, how many joined the El Nido trip only? And letter D, how many did not go to any of the tourist spots?
That ends our lesson today. We hope you learned something. See you on our next episode, Kakyut Angels. Keep safe!